Hello guys, welcome again to Power Learning channel. We are here with the new video and today's topic is very good. Today we will discuss about DeepC704 controller. This controller is for we'll use for generator and also for the ATS. Okay, this is auto mains utility failure control module. So this is a complete video and you can see in this video drawing, connection, wiring, alarms, everything. So watch complete video if you want to understand and you want to get some good knowledge. Keep continue watching and let me start the video. Okay guys, first we have our module in the box. So once you will receive your module, you will find this kind of a box, and after that we will open now the box, and after opening the box we find this is our controller. Okay guys, so let us go and see. This is the back view of our controller. We have total 21 number of wire connections. Okay, and we will see how to do this. So guys, this is our back view of the controller. Okay, here we have total 21 number of terminal. We have two terminal strips from number 1 to 15. We have one terminal strip, and from 16 to 21 we have another terminal strip, and we will explain you in the next slide in details how what is the connection. So let's see about the indications on the module, the protection and the safeties. These are the parameters and value. Okay, our engine oil pressure, whenever we have low engine oil pressure, this indication will be on and we will know that low oil pressure is active. If the module detects that engine oil pressure has fallen below the low oil pressure switch after the safety on timer has expired, a shutdown will occur. The icon will illuminate. Okay, after that, the next is high engine temperature. If the module detects that the engine coolant temperature has exceeded the high engine temperature switch after the safety on timer has expired, a shutdown will occur. The icon will illuminate. This is the icon you see here and also here. So whenever you have high engine temperature, this indication is on and engine is shut down. Okay, the third is over speed. If the engine speed exceeds the preset trip 14% above the nominal frequency, a shutdown is initiated. Over speed is not delayed, it is an immediate shutdown. The icon will illuminate. This icon, you see this icon, it's showing rabbit and it is showing over speed. If this light is on, your over speed protection is on. Okay, the next one, under speed, if the engine speed falls below the preset trip 20% from the nominal frequency after the safety on timer has expired, a shutdown is initiated. The icon will illuminate. This icon, this is our under speed icon. Okay, next is battery charger. What is battery charger? This is dynamo we are talking about here. Dynamo, if the dynamo charging fail, if the module does not detect a voltage from the warning light terminal on the auxiliary charge alternator, the icon will illuminate either 8 volt or 16 volt depending on the configuration of nominal DC voltage. Okay friends, let us see what we have, the remaining 3 lights. Okay, if this light is illuminating, so it's mean our generator is failed to start. If the engine does not fire after the preset 3 attempts at starting, a shutdown will be initiated. This icon will illuminate. This icon, if engine from any reason, if the engine is failed to start, battery is low, diesel is finished, there is problem in the starter motor, so this indication will on if the generator is not started. Okay, the remaining two, it's number 1 and number 2 input. These are two inputs, indication input 1 and input 2 can be configured as warning or shutdown. The relevant icon will be illuminated when the input is active. Okay, this two inputs we can configure, we can program them, okay, and upon this activation of these inputs, these two lights will be on, okay. So next, select desktop, de-energize the fuel solenoid, bringing the generator to stop. If you press this button, stop button, immediately generator will stop. If we want to start generator manually, we have to press this manual button. If we want to activate the auto mode, we have to press this auto mode. This mode is activated by pressing auto push button. An LED indicator beside the button confirm this action, this LED. Once you press this button, this LED is on. Okay. So the next is, let us go on next slide and we will see in details about our terminal connection. Okay guys, here from number 1 to 15, from number 1 to 15, we have all our DC connection, all DC inputs and outputs and power supply. Okay. The next is from 16 to 21. These all are our AC connection, AC voltage, 220 volt or 380 volt connections here. Okay. So let's see what we have on number 1. On number 1, we will connect the plant battery negative. DC plant supply input negative. Okay. On number 2, we will connect the battery positive and we will put 2 ampere fuse in between, fuse or breaker in between in the series of this positive supply. Number 3, we have fuel relay output. Number 4, we have start relay output. Number 5, we have auxiliary relay output. Number 6, auxiliary relay output, relay number 2. On number 7, we will take D positive from the charge alternator and we will connect on number 7. On number 8, we will connect the low oil pressure input from the low oil pressure switch. Number 9, we will connect high engine temperature input. Number 10, we have auxiliary input 1, 11, auxiliary input 2. And on number 12, we will connect the remote start input. On number 13, mains loading relay. Normally open contact and generator loading relay will connect on 14 and the functional earth will connect on number 15. Okay. So after that we have next from number 16 to number 21, number 16, 17, 18 will connect here red, yellow, blue and neutral of the main supply, and then on number 20 alternator L1 and alternator input N, neutral here from the generator. Okay friends, we'll see now in the next slide this drawing. Okay, so first we will connect our this battery to the controller. Okay, let me show you. Okay, here you see this first wire I connect on the negative. Okay, the second number 2 I connect the positive wire and I use fuse here. Okay, you see this is the fuse and I took battery positive from here and directly connected to the positive. Okay, after that I took this positive wire and connect in the charge alternator directly from the battery before the fuse, and I took one more positive via fuse and connect in the two relays, in fuel output relay and the starter relay. After that, these two relay I connected, one with the fuel solenoid and other with the starter motor supply. One direct positive I connected in the starter motor, and this wire I connected the positive supply of the relay, the mains relay. Okay. The main relay positive we will connect directly for ATS control. After that, this red wire, this positive supply will connect directly to our generator contactor relay coil. Okay guys, now I connect here the four inputs, okay, the four outputs from the controller to the four relays. Fuel output relay, start output relay and auxiliary output relays. Okay. After that,
I connect now here. If you see all the negative in common and the negative of dynamo, okay, negative dynamo on number 7. Here we have two blue line, which is one is oil pressure safety and another is engine temperature safety. These two inputs. Okay, after that we have these two brown lines, which is auxiliary alarm input. We can connect anything as per our requirement to these two points and it will give us feedback on the front panel once activated. Here we have remote start. So remote start will be connected on terminal number 12, okay, via ATS switch. Okay, so after that we have, okay guys, so now you will see here we connect the alternator output to the, in the ATS. We connect these four, line 1, line 2, line 3 and neutral in our ATS contactor input side. Okay, and we took two supply 220 volt, okay, from mains control for the controlling purpose and connect here in 2021. Okay, 2021 is generator sensing points via fuse we connect. Okay, and we connect also this line to this contact, relay contact, normally open contact, and connect it to the generator coil. Okay, and the generator neutral coil is directed from taken from the alternator. Okay, after that we connect the output, close gen output, the command from our controller. Okay, now you see here we connect line 1, line 2, line 3 and neutral from the mains utility supply, which is our transformer supply, and in the same way we connect this in our controller fuses. And now this is connected. Okay. Now here we connect the three phase supply to the controller, okay, via fuse. And this positive we connect to this. This is AC supply, normally close relay contact to the mains contactor coil. And this is our close mains output controlling of ATS. Okay, once controlling this, okay, this is relay coil contact. Okay friends, so I hope that till here you have, if you have any question you can comment us. Okay, so if you see here it is showing now the load. This is load. We connected all the four wires, neutral, line 1, line 2, line 3 towards load, and this is common side. If you see now I connect only main side. So now I will connect the generator side also. Look at now, this is our main side also connected. So the load are in common bus now and it is connected to the load. This symbol is showing mechanical interlock protection between these two contactors. Okay, and this wire is showing electrical interlock between these two. This we have to do it externally in our control panel. Okay guys, so I hope you like this video and all the concept is clear for regarding this controller. If you have further any question, you can write us in the comment box. So inshallah we will come back to you, and thank you very much for watching. Have a nice day. Assalamualaikum.